I'm going to recite an excerpt from a Highland Boy by William Wordsworth. Now we are tired of boisterous joy. You have frighted enough, my little boy. Jane lays her head upon my chest, and you shall take a stool and rest. The corner is yours. There, take a seat, and let me see that you can listen quietly. And as promised, I shall tell the strange adventures that befell the poor blind Highland Boy. A Highland Boy? Why call him so? Because, my dear darlings, he must know, under hills, high as towers, far higher than ours, he has lived since birth. He's never seen an earthly sight, the sun, the day, the stars, the night, a tree, butterfly, or flower, a fish and stream, or bird and bower, a man, woman, or child. And yet, he never drooped nor pined, nor had a melancholy mind, for God took pity on the boy. He was a friend, he gave him joy, of which we nothing know. His mother, too, knew Dad above. Her other children him did love, for she was here or she was there. She thought of him with constant care, more than mother's love. And proud she was of heart when clad in Christmas stockings, tartan plaid, and feather on bonnet, oh so gay, to kirk he went on Sabbath day, hand in hand with her. A dog, too, he had, not of need, but to play with, to feed, and it would have led him, if bereft of company and friends had left, without a better guide. And the bagpipes he could blow, and thus house to house would go, and all were pleased to hear and see, for none made a sweeter melody than poor blind boy. And yet he had many restless dreams, all of which eagles scream and torrents roar, near where their cottage stood. By a lake their cottage stood, not like ours, a peaceful flood, but mighty in size and strange, neither rough or smooth, full of change, stirring in its bed. And to this lake, night and day, the mighty sea water finds its way through long winding hills that drinks of pretty rills and rivers large and strong. And it goes the way it came, running errands still the same. And it has done since the earth was new, and it shall evermore do until the earth shall exist. And with the coming of the tide, ships and boats safely ride between woods and lofty rocks, with shepherds and their flocks bring tales of distant lands. And in the highland dwell, still they keep the turtle shell, and the story shall repeat of the boy's adventurous feat in which he was preserved. Thank you.